One question that we get online a lot is how can you walk in an attic with insulation on the floor? Let's talk about it. Well, first, let's quickly establish there's a couple different ways that you can insulate an attic. And when I say floor or flat, I'm talking about the actual, if you're standing in the attic, the floor part of your attic, if you have insulation on that. That's mostly what we're going to talk about today. The other way to insulate an attic is to put insulation on the roof deck, the underside of the roof of your attic itself. Now, again, in this situation, obviously it'd be very easy to walk in the attic. You can see the studs, you can run boards and such, because there's nothing on the floor or the flat. But let's talk more specifically about if you do have insulation on the floor of your attic. Well, the key to walking around an attic with insulation on the floor is to make sure you put all of your weight or your boards or whatever on the studs or the trusses of your attic. Do not walk on your drywall. You will learn that lesson very quickly. Gravity is not forgiving. When you're walking or when you're setting up things on the attic itself, again, it's super important to make sure you keep everything as lined up with those floor joists as possible. Some people will want to run boards or runners or walkways throughout their attic if they do want to use it for storage or to get to mechanicals, if there's appliances up there, whatever the case may be. One thing that could make that complicated is if you have insulation that goes above those floor trusses or those floor joists. If you do have insulation that goes above that, well, if it's a fibrous material, move it out of the way. It's very easy to move and you can put your boards there and now you have an established walkway. Now, if you have something like foam insulation, again, relatively simple. You may have to cut some of that foam out. If it's open cell spray foam, very easy to cut. You can use a bread knife or you can use your hands and just tear chunks of it out if you had to. But very easy to work with. Now, one thing you might be thinking of, well, if I take any insulation out or if I move some of that insulation, well, now I've lost some R value or I've lost some insulating capability because I've now, you know, taken away some insulation. That's true. That's the trade-off. You have the convenience of having access and using your attic for possible storage or other things. But the trade-off is that in those areas for the walkways or the storage areas, whatever, you will lose some R value in those areas. You have to accept that trade-off if you want to use the attic space for storage or whatever the case. That's kind of the pro and con to that scenario, and you have to decide for yourself, is it worth it having storage capabilities or being able to easily walk throughout my attic knowing I'm gonna lose some heat or a little bit heat more so in these areas because there's less insulation. That's where you'll have to decide, is it worth it for you? But the reality is if you do choose to take some out or move some to create a walkway, yes, that area will be slightly less insulated. So if you're doing research on attic insulation and you're thinking about making your house more energy efficient, do yourself a favor. Click our link below to our Learning Center. We have all kinds of articles, videos, and blogs talking about attic insulation, everything that you need to know to make your home more energy efficient. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.